Very good day to all of you. Today's video lecture series will focus on the module 5. The lecture series is 48, the continuation of the previous one. This will focus on the concepts of programming of stepper motors. I, Professor Prasanna Kulkarni, working as assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering from KLS VDIIT Haliyal, is presenting this video lecture series. The contents which I'm going to cover in today's topic will focus upon the construction details of stepper motors and their programming in assembly and C language. This will be of level of L3, which will give you a brief understanding about writing programs. With the knowledge of understanding what you have done in the previous video lecture series, now we can focus upon the applying concepts, how we can apply the concepts to write the programs for stepper motors. After this lecture series, the student will have better understanding of construction of the stepper motor and various applications which can be done by programming. The previous video lecture series has focused upon the concepts on the construction details of stepper motors, the placement of rotors, the usage of various step angles used, how do you perform clockwise and anti-clockwise rotations, and also have discussed some important concept on steps per second that we perform and also the calculation of the step angle. With this brief idea, now we can understand the various concepts on these stepper motors with respect to their programs. As far as the Bloom's taxonomy is considered, this video lecture series will have a note about the level of L3, which will talk about the application level. So by understanding the previous ideas and concepts in this today's video lecture series, we'll go for application level. That is, using the previous information, we are able to solve some problems. So let us go to the programs of this 8051. So the first one, write an ALP to rotate the stepper motor clockwise as well as in anti-clockwise continuously with the full step sequence. So in the previous video lecture series, we have gone through the full step sequences, how it can be performed, okay, and the same has been concept has been used here for writing of programs. So let us focus on this. Move a comma hash 66. So why the 66 is used here? We can observe the first step angle what we have used for full step sequence. So if I write the 66H in binary notations, how can it be written? Okay, 0 110 followed by 0 110. Okay, so we can observe that 0 110 is nothing but two phase on full step sequence. So therefore, initially accumulator is copied with a value of 66. Now since our stepper motor is connected to port P1, only 4 lines are connected to that, so therefore I just make a data present in accumulator copied to P1, assuming that P1 port is connected to the line driver ULN2003A, because line driver will have only 4 inputs from a port, okay, remaining 4 are copied, same replicated sequences. So therefore move P1 comma accumulator, so P1 will get 66, but what is your actual sequence is 6. Okay, next, to perform the clockwise direction, what is the next sequence that we want? Okay, it is a rotation right. So therefore the full step sequence, which is meant for two phase on, can be simply be bought by rotation right of accumulator. So what I do every time, I will rotate the accumulator for the right side. Rather than copying a new sequence, I can generate the new sequence by available data by simply performing rotation. Therefore I'll be using a available instruction called as rotate right accumulate. So once you call an accumulator to be rotated right, I call a delay function. Okay, because the stepper motor is connected to line driver. Line driver will have a buffer. So before you drive a stepper motor, the value has to be copied and it should be saved on the buffer amplifier. Therefore, until buffer amplifier reads the data, I should not force the next data immediately. And therefore I call a delay. So every time I put a content on port, I call a delay function. So for stepper motor, always we need that small delay value before I post next data. So what will happen in the present program? Once you go for a call delay, you directly jump to delay program. So delay is a subroutine. Whatever you're writing, a call delay is a subroutine. So when I go to delay, how do we generate delay function for assembly program? What I'll do? Move R1 with some value, hash 100, decimal number. Move R2 comma hash 50, a decimal number. I simply decrement R2 first. DJNZ, decrement, jump till no zero. R2 comma up. So you are executing the same instruction again, again and again for 50 times. 50 times. Then, after you complete R2 getting 0, what is the next line for your execution? Is DJNZ R1 comma up 1. What is up 1? That R1 has to be decremented. For every R1 decrement, R2 should be executed for 50 times. The delay is very simple. Now, how much is the total delay executed by this code? It is 100 into 50. 100 into 50, that is 5000. 5000 is a total delay time for sending next data. So this is called as nesting. Okay, this is concept is called as nesting. So when you want to create large delay, we use this concept of nesting. Okay, after once the delay is called, I will return. Now what is the next return function? Return function go to the call delay function. What is the next line of call delay? Short jump back. So you are moving back to load the next data to port 1. And therefore, for every rotation write, that new data is posted to port 1 and a delay function is called. Successfully, your motor will keep on rotating continuously in clockwise direction. In clockwise direction. Now, same thing if I want to do it for anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise. What I have to do? I have to simply make my sequence reverted. Reversed. How it is possible? Instead of rotation right accumulator, you have to only replace that instruction by rotate left accumulator instruction. If you do rotate left, default your stepper motor will produce the sequence for anti-clockwise rotation. Rest of the program will remain to be the same. I think everybody have understood. Very simple program to make a stepper motor to run in clockwise and anti-clockwise rotation. So let's go to a much advanced program than the first one, okay, in the second slide. So second slide will show you now what exactly we want to do it in this is a switch is connected to pin P2.7. Write an ALP to monitor the status of the switch. If the switch position is 0, the motor moves clockwise, and if a switch position is 1, motor moves anti-clockwise. This can be very much compared to the previous video series application, wherein we have seen box rotation. So based upon the switch which is pressed, if switch is 0, the motor should move clockwise, and when the switch is pressed 1, the motor should move anti-clockwise. Okay, so one of the best application which you can use for even the garage or opening and closing of the shop shutters, okay, because they are very heavy. It is not possible manually to do all this. So that time we can easily do this. One of the best examples, live applications of this. Okay, so based upon switch position, the rotation has to change. That is the meaning of this program. So let us write this. ORG initialization, we have done it. Set B P2.7, because we have to make 2.7 as input. Therefore, set B P2.7. Now 2.7 is a input pin for us. Then we are able to read whatever comes on 2.7, it is our switch value. Okay, next, already we have written a program for clockwise. I will derive the same thing here. Move A comma hash 66. I think everybody knows. I will not again elaborate this. Move P1 comma A. This I think also everybody knows it, right? Okay, next, what is my job? To check the position of the switch. How do you check this? Using instruction. Jump if no bit is set. JNB stands for jump if no bit is set. Which bit I have to check for? 2.7. I have to look for 2.7. If it is not a set, I should go to a label. What is the label? CW. If it is not set, I should go to CW. Not set, the meaning is that switch position is 0. And once it is 0, motor should go to what? clockwise direction. So let us go to first CW. So in the CW label, you can observe, in the CW, I'm having rotate right accumulator. Okay, so rotating right accumulator. Content is already loaded. I'm only rotating right. And I call a delay function, delay program also I have derived from the previous as it is. Everything I'm doing from the previous idea. Short jump, turn. Short jump will go to turn. Turn means read the switch position once again. It will perform the clockwise rotation. Fine. After that, you should again read the switch position. If the switch immediately gets changed, you should stop there itself. So therefore, short jump, go to turn. Turn label. In the turn label, again you are verifying what is the switch position. Now, if this time it is 1, what will happen? Program will not jump to CW label. It will directly go to next line. What is in the next line? Rotate left accumulator. So when you do rotate left accumulator, obviously what will happen now? Motor will go for anti-clockwise rotation. And then you again repeat the same sequence. What is the repetition now? Delay is required. Again, you use the same delay program. This is the advantage of subroutine. I think now everybody have got to know why we use subroutine programs. Subroutine program can be shared by multiple fragments of the program, and you will save lot of programming space. When you become an embedded engineer, this concept is very much required. Subroutine declaration, because both program has to do the same job. Why can't they share the same code? And that sharing of code is nothing but subroutine programs. So once you call that delay, it will again go to the same delay program, does the same amount of delay, comes back because of the return function, goes back. And in the going back function, again you are going for short jump, turn. So once you go to again short jump, turn, again you are verifying what is your switch position. And every time this becomes a continuous program, every time based upon the switch position, the motor can perform clockwise as well as anti-clockwise rotations. I think everybody have understood what exactly program is going to do in this when switch position is monitored. So third one, wherein we'll talk about some angle of rotations. Okay, this is very required program for us. Write an ALP to rotate a motor 90 degrees clockwise. Only 90 degrees. I don't want this to do continuous clockwise like what we did in the previous program. Okay, only 90 degrees clockwise rotation it has to do and it should stop. Don't want anything after this. And the step angle of the motor is 2 degrees. Okay, so before you write a program, we should do a small exercise on this. First of all, you have to note down what is step angle. 2 degrees. Okay, fine. So how many steps are required per revolution? Okay, please remember this. The revolution is 360 degrees. Okay, so how many steps you need for entire 360 degrees? How many steps are required? Because each step is 2 degrees. How many steps per revolution? 180. So 180 steps required for 360 degrees. Then only for 90 degrees, how much is the steps required? Or it is also called as number of rotor teeth. How much is the step angle that is required? How much is the number of steps required for 90 degrees? 45. Correct. So therefore, for 90 degree rotation, the number of steps is 45. Very simple calculation. So 45 into 2 gives you 90 degrees. Each step is of 2 degrees. 45 steps into 2 degrees will give you 90 degrees. Did you get this point? Then get into the program. ORG MOA 66. Okay, two phase on sequence I'm going to use. No, next line is a modification. MOV R0, #45. That 45 in decimal. See that. Please observe this. 45 written in decimal. MOV R0, #45. Okay. Then next one. Rotate right accumulator, because I have to provide clockwise rotation. Rotate right accumulator. Then MOV P1, A. This sequence to be sent to port 1. If you don't send this, line driver will not get the value. If line driver do not get a value, motor won't rotate. Okay, so MOV P1, accumulator is a must. You connect port P1 to motor, assuming that this program is written. All the programs are written with that reference. Then you call a delay program, or call delay. Okay, and you know the delay program, therefore I have not included that in the program. So we can use the same delay program every time. Fine, therefore I have not included in my slide. Next, this is very important. So after you call a delay, what you have to do? You should check for your R0 value. DJNZ R0, back. Until unless R0 is not 0, you should keep on doing this job again and again. Once R0 has completed, so because for every delay value, your DJNZ R0 will happen. Decrement of R0 will happen. So therefore, number of times this will get executed 45. Each angle is 2 degrees. Okay, each angle is 2 degrees and you are doing it for 45 times. So how much is the total degree that is traversed? 90 degrees. 90 degrees you are performing is a clockwise rotation. I think you have understood very simple a change that is to be incorporated in the program lines. Okay, so everybody have understood this. Now let us go to another step, which is called as half step sequence. Half step, because all these programs you have written for full step, we'll focus another program on half step. So rotate the stepper motor continuously clockwise using half step. What do you mean by half step? 8 step sequences. Full step means only 4 step. Half step means 8 step sequences will happen. Okay, and these sequences to be stored in ROM location. Now how to do this? ORG, okay, initialization, we have done it. Move R0, 08. Now here I am using this 08 for counter, because half step will have 8 sequences. So therefore, to check which sequence, I have kept that as a counter. Okay, next one. Move DPTR, hash, half step. Directly go to the last line of the program. You can observe. Half step DB 09, 08, 0C, 04, 06, 02, 03, 01. These are the values for your half step sequences. If you want, you can go back to the table. You can check this. The same values are being bought here also. 8 sequences are being made available. Okay, now here you cannot do rotation right and left. The reason, because sequences are not accordingly. So therefore, you have to store those sequences in a ROM. Okay, and storing is very simple as such. ORG 0200, this is your storage of ROM memory location. In that storage, you have created a label. The label name is half step. All the values are of byte size DB and you have stored the sequence. Okay, this is how the data are stored in ROM locations. Has everybody understood this? Okay, next one. Coming back to this. Move DPTR, hash, half step. So ultimately your DPTR will point to 0200. Okay, internally for a machine. Move DPTR, hash, 0200. Correct? Clear accumulator. First of all, I will clear my accumulator. Right? MOVC, because you are storing your sequence in ROM. ROM is what called as code memory. So therefore, you cannot use very simple instructions. MOV and MOVX are not permitted. Because your data is stored in ROM, you have to use MOVC as the only instruction available. MOVC A, @A plus DPTR. So it is an indexed addressing mode wherein accumulator is made 0. So therefore 0 plus DPTR. By default, you are in 0200H. Whatever is the content present in that location is copied to accumulate. This is the meaning of this instruction. So what is the first value which is available? 09 is copied to accumulator. And that 09 is given to port 1, P1. Okay. Next, call a delay program. The concept is same, calling a delay. And here also I have not written delay program, because delay program is same used like a previous one. Okay. So delay is not been shown in the program, but you have to write a delay program. When it is in actual, you have to write it. Okay. Once that delay is completed, what is my next job? Read the next sequence. Once the delay is completed, my job is to read the next sequence. How do I read the next sequence here? By incrementing DPTR. So once you increment DPTR, obviously, what is the next data in my sequence? 08. Right. Also, I have to check the sequence R completed and total length of sequence is 8. If you don't use a counter, it will take even all the garbage values and your motor will not perform any correct rotation. So therefore, the counter is used. Once you fetch a value, next value, your counter has to be decremented by 1. So therefore, I use DJNZ R0, repeat, RPT, repeat, label. What repeat label do again? Clear accumulator. So previous sequence is erased. The next sequence is again copied into accumulator. From accumulator sent to P1, delay is called. This will happen incrementing DPTR, fetch a next value and decrement the count. So therefore, because of the count is 8, only 8 sequences will be fetched. Only 8 sequences will be fetched. And if you want to do this continuously, I simply go for short jump start. So run the program, same program once again. So this is how a half step angle rotation program is written for stepper motor. Suppose if I ask you, okay, change this program for anti-clockwise. What is your possible solutions? If this is an assignment for you, what you will do? Very simple job. Okay, here there is no rotation right, rotation left. You cannot do that. If your answer is rotation left and right, you are wrong. What I have to do? Make the sequence in a reverse order. Okay, whatever sequence you have got, 09, 08, 0C, 04, 06, 02, 03, 01, write in a reverse order. What is reverse order? 1, 3, 2, 6, 4, C, 8, 9. If you do this, same program will do anti-clockwise rotation using half step. I think everybody understood this program now. Okay. So now we'll go to the next line of a program. Because we are only getting used to assembly level programs, we should be even good in C level also. So next programs will focus on the C level programs, C language programs. So programming stepper motor with 8051 C programs. Okay. Now, what is the program requirement is? Write an ALP to rotate the stepper motor clockwise anti-clockwise continuously with full step sequence. Okay, this is the same program which are doing, which have done already using assembly level program, but the same program using C, how to do it. So the hash include RG51, wide main, while one, forever, I want to run this program. So what is the first sequence I give? P1 is equal to 0x66, very correct. Port 1 is directly fed, no accumulator, nothing required. Direct you can move value to port 1. This is the advantage of C programs. Okay, because you are available with the ready operators, or also called as built-in operators in C language, which will readily facilitate you. Whatever you want, you move data directly to there. Okay, which is not possible in assembly level program. You cannot directly move value. Here you can easily do this. Move P1, instead of that, P1 is equal to 0x66. Then call a delay program. There we use subroutine. Here we use function. The name of the function is msDelay200. Okay, 200 is a value which is passed to that delay function. So 166 is passed. What is the next value that we need to pass? Okay, is 33. So this can be even done by a shift operation also. If you are good in operators of C language, this can be easily done by one shift rotation operation. Shift right by one. Okay, that also can be done, or you can directly post a sequence to port 1. P1 is equal to 0x33. Again, call a delay function of same size of delay. Third one is 99. Fourth sequence is CC. This is simply loading the sequence to that. Okay, now how to write a delay functions for C programs? How to write a delay function in C? So let us see that in the next slide. MSDelay200. This is what a function which has been called every time whenever I pass a value. So next function declaration, how it has been done? Void ms delay, unsigned character value. So default that value variable will be replaced by 200, which will be replaced by 200. Now what we are doing is unsigned int x and y. I'll be using for loop for x is 0, x less than 1 to 75, x plus plus. This will give you 1 millisecond delay. Okay, this for loop x equal to 0, x less than 1 to 75, x plus plus will give you 1 millisecond of delay. Everybody understood this? 1 millisecond of delay. Okay. Next, for nested for loop, for y is 0, y less than value, y plus plus. Now, this will execute the loop for 200 times. So, what is the total delay that you are going to call here? 1 millisecond multiplied by 200. So, 200 millisecond is a delay between reading of two sequences for a stepper motor. Okay, 200 millisecond is a delay which is being used. So please practice these programs, try to write on your own. Okay, try to write delay functions, try to write your own programs for this. Suppose in the same program, if I ask an assignment also, I want to do an anti-clockwise rotation for the same program, what you will do? What is the change that you want to do in this program? Yes. Okay, so just reverse the sequence. What is the reversing? CC993366. Very correct. If you do this, same program will perform an anti-clockwise rotation. Okay, so and let us go to the next one of similar type, what we did know previously, Okay, let us do this with a C program now. Fine? Okay. A switch is connected to P2.7. Write an ALP. If switch position is 0, it should move clockwise. If switch position is 1, it should do anti-clockwise. But in C program, how do you write this? Hash include S bit. Okay, S bit, SWP2.7. Void main declaration. And I make SWS 1. If you make this only, then switch becomes an input switch for us. SW is 1. Okay. Then while one loop continuously, it is an infinite loop which is created. Then I check for position. If SW is equal to 0, here it is a question mark. Are you 0? Switch, are you 0? If you 0, I have to do clockwise rotation. And I already have written clockwise rotation. P1 is 0x66, call a delay. Then P1 is 33, call a delay. P1 is 99, call a delay. P1 is CC, call a delay. For a switch position 0, very correct. Next, when switch position is 1, when I need not to check here, what I do simply else. I simply use else function. Okay, because my job is to just check whether it is 1 or 0. If it is not 0, obviously it will be 1. So I need not again put if loop. Okay, this is what normally we do errors in the code. Okay, we should not do it here. If switch is 0, execute it, else execute this. Again, don't ask, are you still 1? Okay, so please don't do such logical errors in the program. Else, simply it is an else function. P1, 0x66, then a delay function CC, delay function 99, delay function 33 is a delay function. I can observe that sequence has been reversed. 66, I directly then go for CC, then I go for 99, then I go for 33. Okay, the same program can be also extended for full step angle sequences also. I think this has given you a very brief idea how to write programs for stepper motors, how to write for a precise angle of control. I want to only stop for 90 degrees, both for clockwise, anti-clockwise, not only for 90 degrees, for different angles of rotations also. How do you write program for these stepper motors? I think you have got a brief idea about this programming of stepper motors. I think this has given you enough knowledge on how do you interface these motors, how do you write program for these motors, for stepper motor interconnections also. With this brief note, I would say that the references what I've used for this is from 8051 Microcontroller Embedded Systems using Assembly and C Edition by using Muhammad Ali Mazidi. Please make use of this textbook. It is really good, and a lot of programming concepts are being covered, and I prefer that for programming, please refer this. And for theoretical knowledge of this, you can go to Introduction to Microcontrollers by using Kenneth Ayala, 3rd edition. And for the knowledge on stepper motors, okay, theoretical knowledge on stepper motor, you can still refer to 8051 Microcontroller Based Embedded Systems by Manish Patel. Okay, so these are various references you can make use of. And with this brief note, I just say thank you for attending to this video lecture series. That definitely these materials will help you to prepare for your examinations. Thank you, one and all.